so today we are playing Yoshi's Island on the Snes Classic. And without further ado, let's get into the game. One thing I love about this thing, it kept the graphics from the 16-bit era. And the adventure begins! Let's go! Welcome to Yoshi's Island. This is the rules of the game. Gotta say, as a kid, this was like my favorite Mario game. I never owned this game actually. I would go over to my cousin's house just to play this game actually. As a kid, I love stories play. Pretty much the plan here is to play through the whole world every video and just record from there. I'm planning on doing other stuff too, like maybe doing a Mega Man X, because it comes with this thing, and like Gun Country, Star Fox, Castlevania. Especially Castlevania, I'm like, I haven't played the game in like years, so I'm excited to play that one too. And Earthbound, of course. And maybe Final Fantasy 3, I'm not sure about that. Might be too long to stream or to record videos on. Anyway, I hope everybody's day is going well. That's Sunday? Yeah, that's Sunday today. Speaking of which, shout out to my fans team. Actually don't really know this year, which I'm excited about. Not doing too bad this season, which just makes me happy. But enough about football. So pretty much, I got this thing, the SNES Classic Mini. I actually got an accident. It wasn't meant to happen. I wasn't planning on ever getting it because of the disappointment that was the NES Classic. With them always being sold out, and then just randomly saying, oh, we're not gonna sell anymore, we're not making any more of them. It's just a disappointment right there. And well, what happened was during an Uber trip, I went Uber that day. I let a girl in because she wanted Uber order. I took her to GameStop. And I was like, wait, but you don't get up until 10, right? She's like, oh yeah, but they have the SNES Classic today, so I wanted to get one for my boyfriend. I was like, oh, that's cool. I was like, wait, I saw the line. I was like, well, I want to see about 6-7 people on that line. I was like, dude, I was like, I might as well just take a chance and just stay. Alright, so I get in the line, I'm waiting with the people. About 5 minutes later, GameStop guy comes out, starts giving out tickets. There are numbers on them. He said he had about 10. So basically when he gets to me, I'm like, oh, I'm not gonna get one. Well, you know what, I was number 8 actually on the list. For ticket, number 8 to get tickets. So I decided to stay in his way, wait out and see what would happen when the pre-orders got there first, and they got theirs first. See, I figured maybe, you know, maybe I wouldn't get one. I was the last one to get, actually. I was the last one to get their Snes Classic. So yeah, that's my funny story for today. Moral story, take chances whenever you can. Yeah, no one experience will ever be the same. Oh fuck. Dang it! One thing I love about these games too is the music was just so, like, happy and, like, happy, it's too cool. I just love that. Well, also what I miss is, like, these are the kind of games you can just, like, pick up and play. You don't have to be, like, really have any kind of skill to play with, you know? None of the games nowadays where you have to be good, or else you're not gonna have fun with the game because online play, everybody's already, like, mastered it, and they're like, oh, like Call of Duty, the whole like, you just basically get destroyed every 5 seconds if you not get out of that game. Same thing with fighting games, same thing with adventure games, it's like, yeah. One thing I'll say about these kind of games too, well, my gripe, my only gripe would be, I would say, is the whole graphics thing. It's not a gripe on my side, but a gripe for like a younger generation kind of gamer, because I feel this generation was spoiled by beautiful graphics like Skyrim, like The Last of Us, like Call of Duty. So I just feel like this generation of gamers is probably spoiled as it pertains to like video games and how they're supposed to look, you know. Like, you know, Breath of the Wild and all the little games that actually require a system to play. We're at the 9 minute mark, okay. I'm gonna work on this. Also, what I love about this SNES Classic too is the borders. You can change like the colors, I guess, of like the frame of all the games. on the outside. So you're not like a matrix, you kinda like designed because playing Mega Man for a while. Just testing out and stuff. Oh yeah, speaking of which, I also wanna do a gauntlet trick course. I wanna do a co-op series with that one probably. A few games on here that could be cool. Besides Street Fighter, or something like fighting game. And Mighty Contra Alien Wars, which is like, in my point of view, one of the best Contras actually. One of the hardest, but still the best. This is the bonus game. Yeah. I hate it. Easily. No, it's okay. I gotta go for it. Basically, you have to, like, throw the balloon back before it pops. I bring in the right connection. No, he's holding it. He's popping on me. Yes! Oh no. Ah! Another Yeah. I also when I realize I have more time to focus on this. So make sure I don't die in front of all the time. Yes. Like I said before, I hope to make more videos with different games. I'll turn on this one. I plan on like playing the whole, pretty much doing the whole playthrough on this, about this game. Which should be about 8 videos, but there's only about 8 or 6, I'm already sure. Let's see. I really like the whole different Yoshis thing. Different kind of Yoshis. Flipping the cards for items. Okay. Split in two episodes probably because YouTube probably is not really one because six too long. Thank you.
Hey!
mean, this would be like the last level I play. Maybe the other one I play. No, okay. Start work again next week. I mean, tomorrow I start work again. Work in school again, so, yeah. Every time you beat a stage, just starts building up the world. The Yoshis took over our world. Alright. You guys have a good rest of your day.